Hi there.
We're still at Leica. I'm playing with lenses, and I'm here with the head of the lens area. His name's Peter Carver. What actually is your title, so I can get it straight?
I'm head of department, development optics. Yes.
Development optics. You've been with Leica for 30 years, plus
yes.
years?
Yes, right? That's right. I've been with Leica for 30 years now, yes.
And he's responsible for a lot of the lenses that you have on these Leica cameras. And I got to tell you, you've really got to pick this stuff up and hold it and try it. To feel the smoothness of the way this lens moves in and out for its focus and the f-stops and the clicks are just absolutely amazing. But while we sit here and admire the lenses all we want, what we really want to do is talk to Peter about lens design. To me, one of the biggest backbones of Leica has always been the quality of the lenses. The fact that they can take small lenses like this and pull remarkable quality out of them is just absolutely stunning. And we've talked a lot about the look of a Leica image. Yeah. And a lot of it has to do with the design of the lenses. So maybe you can tell us a little bit about how that all comes to be.
Yes, I think the look of the Leica lenses comes from first the design on the one side, and on the other side, on the production, the quality in the production. These are two pillars to realize such a good Leica look, as I think. And the design is historical developed, so we have a very long tradition in designing lenses for 35 millimeter format. So we have our own philosophy to design these lenses and to control the aberrations. And aberrations to control is very easy when you add more lens elements, but unfortunately we are not able to implement so many lens elements. Otherwise the lens wouldn't be so small. So
one of the things that you say that your 35 years or the tradition is to have less elements.
Exactly, yes. Less elements and best performance. This is a combination we try to realize always.
And it's not easy.
No, it's not easy. You need to know how to control the aberrations, how to fix the problems in the production. The problems means the tight tolerances. To realize tight tolerances is the other thing I think we have to highlight at this point. It's not only design. Designing is one thing. The whole production line is the other thing, yes.
No, but I mean, aberration is something that really is the bane of a lot of lenses,
yes.
You know, from a lot of different companies. And the fact that you're managing it, and I think what you shared with me earlier is that you've worked so hard on this aberration issue,
yes.
That you recommend and tell everybody that you should shoot the lens wide open or to the f-stop that is proper for the subject that you're shooting, rather than just try to find a sweet spot, as a lot of us have heard throughout the years.
Yes, thank you very much. That's very important to highlight. We design our lenses to be used wide open as much as possible, because the lenses are perform very well wide open, not only stopping down or stop down if you need the depth of focus or depth of field, but the lenses are designed to be used wide open, so to get a three-dimensional impression of your image by using the small depth of focus. This is very important for us, and we think the effect is that the Leica look itself is the consequence of that. We design the lens to be used wide open, yes.
As a photographer, and Peter's a photographer too, actually, just as a side note, one of the things that's amazed me so far through this journey with Leica is the passion for photography that everybody we've sat down with and talked to are all about. You shared with me earlier, you love to do nature and, you know, go out and photograph, you know, the small things out there and so forth. So, these just aren't engineers, you know, sitting down with a challenge. These are engineers and designers making a product that they want to use and you
yes.
want to use. And,
exactly.
You know, it's kind of like, oh, I can't wait to yeah. get this off the drawing board and on my camera so I can see yeah. what it does.
Also, this thinking about the use of the product we produce or we develop has a long tradition. So Max Berek, the first optical designer at Leica, also thought through how good needs a lens to be so that the photographer or the customer will be satisfied. And so he you also set the target by thinking as a customer. So,
well, so tell us a little bit. You told me the story earlier that he photographed a postcard.
Yes.
When this was back in.
So he took a photographed postcard, a printed postcard, and he counted the dots. How many dots do I need to get a good postcard, printed postcard? And he found out that 1 million dots are sufficient for a postcard. And with this knowledge, he defines the design targets for the system, for the lens. So 30 microns, he said, is a circle of confusion we have to realize minimum.
And so this has been the target, actually. You won't probably say this on camera, but let's just say Leica goes way beyond what the 30 micron target is in their design idea. But no matter what, you're going to get this beautiful 30 micron standard that's been part of the Leica lens lineup for all these years.
So today we have higher targets. Not the postcard, it's the printed size we are thinking about. Yes, so bigger sizes, or what can you image on the monitor? Such things we think through.
You know, there's a lot of other lenses that are going into the Leica lens line. We're going to be visiting the SL line, and we don't have the SL line. We do have them, but we're just playing with these because these are so much fun to handle. But there's the SL line, and you've started developing the zooms, real true zoom autofocus. So some of your design parameters have had to be completely different now that you've entered the autofocus market and the zoom lens market.
Yeah, exactly. Due to the fact that we have an autofocus system with contrast autofocus, we had to follow the targets defined by the electronics. So electronics says we need special motors. So in this case, it's stepper motors. And stepper motors require very light focusing elements. And so we had completely to think through how to realize such a system with inner focus light weight autofocus groups, yes, and this was completely new for us, and we started from scratch in this direction, yes.
You shared with me that you have a software that you've developed that helps you develop and make these lenses, and this software obviously is proprietary, and it dates back to how long? Back in?
I think 50 years or
50
more.
50 years.
Or more. In 1950s they started to do that, yes. With SUSE, yes. With the first computer, SUSE computer. Perhaps you know, it's a German computer.
No, I don't know it, but you know, I trust it must be a pretty darn good computer at the time to do this.
Yeah. And Professor Marx was the head of developing this computer programs, yes, named COMO. And we, with this design software, we have a special look at the aberrations, as I talked before, yes. So we have to minimize the aberrations at the same time by reducing the lens elements we need. So this is always in contradiction. But we always try to find out to get the best with less surfaces.
What you're saying, and I think it's important for readers to understand, is that a lot of lens companies and other manufacturers put more elements, more groups, and so forth into the lens. Yet you have a specific goal with the design of Leica lenses to minimize the number of elements that go into a lens.
Yes.
And that also contributes to the fact that you get less chance for the light and everything to go as, I don't know if I can use the word astray, but.
Exactly, yes.
And so it's pretty important. Now, there are two other aspects I want to talk about, and one of them is glass. You hear a lot about Leica glass. Maybe you can tell us about glass a little bit.
So also this is a story about the history of Leica, because after World War II, Leitz invented or introduced a Leitz glass laboratory, and we designed or developed our own glass materials, very, very nice glass materials to perform good lenses. And this knowledge about the glass material we still have. Of course, today everybody can use this glass material, but we are very familiar with that in using this for the design and using this in the production line. Because you need to know that these glass materials we implement, especially for apochromatic correction and such things, these glass materials are very, very sensitive and not easy to handle in the production. so or in the optical shop. And so our craftsmanship in the optical shop need to know how to use this glass material. Sometimes this glass material is very soft, yes, very, very soft, so you have to handle it with care. And others are very sensitive for air pollution and such things, so corrosion appears, and so you need to know how to handle this glass material. This is very important. For us as a designer, it is, but it's a good opportunity to use these glass materials to reduce the aberrations with less
Once
elements.
Once again, the main challenge.
The main challenge, yes. So this is, I think that's a trade-off, I think this is the right name, yes?
Yep.
Yes, the knowledge in the production line and the knowledge in the design need to be combined to get the best performance at the end, yes.
And there's also coatings.
Coating, yes. Coating is very important in this context because the very sensitive glass material need to be protected. So we have coating with low reflection on the one side, but also these coatings need to protect the lens elements so that the corrosion will not appear suddenly.
Yeah.
This production line is very well defined, so polishing, centering the lens and directly coating, so that we get a very low reflection on the one side and protection on the other side. That's very important for us.
Now, I saw a video on your site about the lenses and that the side of the lenses are all painted or hand. So there's no machines doing some of this stuff. I mean, there's some machines doing grinding, but there's a lot of handwork that's involved. And, you know, the sides and the lenses are all painted individually. Is that correct?
Mm. Individually by hand. And the reason for this is that we didn't find an automatic way to paint the edges, but this is very important for the cosmetics, so that you don't see any dicks or whatever, and they need to be very black inside of the lens. So, and this is the reason why we use this special method to paint. Yes.
And every lens is individual, meaning there's a way of measuring so that if you have to, you can make individual adjustments on the center of the lens and the way it sits inside so that specifically the tolerances are met really well.
As I said, use the lens wide open as often as possible because wide open the performance is there. You can get the best performance wide open. But to realize that, we need to handle very tight tolerances. But to be honest, we can't reduce the tolerances down to zero, but to get at the same time the best performance as a result in the lens system, we use special compensators during the production so that our employees are able to correct some deviations for the single element tolerances, so at the end you get the best performance for each lens.
Mm-hmm.
And this is handmade.
Literally, you know, handmade.
That, yes.
There's so many elements. And we're going to go visit manufacturing so we can show how some of this is done in one of the future segments. But when you hold the final result, it's just absolutely amazing. When you work with it, it's absolutely amazing. Peter, I want to thank you for sitting down with us. It's nice to meet the individual that's behind a lot of this. I just can't help but admire the quality that's built into every lens that I've touched over the last several days. So my recommendation to our viewers is that you should get down to a Leica store sometime soon and get a lens, put it on a camera, not only shoot with it, but appreciate it. Because I think that's probably one of the big things about a Leica camera is once you own one, there's a lot of appreciation that goes into it. It's unique to each lens, each camera, but there's just something special about it. And my hat is off to you as the designer of, you know, these amazing pieces of glass and how good it is in such a small size.
Thank you very much.
So it's been a pleasure meeting with you. And like I said, I hope we get a chance to bump into everybody again. And I'll see you guys on the Lunas Landscape.